Hi, thanks for joining me. This is Angie at Chicken Scratch, and this is the project we're making today. Okay, so this is our box of the week, and this is number 3. Okay, so the supplies you're going to need is a basic black cardstock that measures 6.5 by 11. Then you're going to need a piece of Daffodil Delight and a piece of Very Vanilla. The stamp set that we're using is Halloween Treat. And we're using this cute owl. So I'm going to go ahead and stamp her or him. I'm using Tangelo Twist ink. I'm going to give that a second to dry, and we're going to go ahead and make our box real quick. I've got the Simply Scored scoring tool. I'm going to place this in landscape mode. I'm going to score at 1.5. 4.75, 6.25, and 9.5. Okay, so now it's in portrait mode, and I'm going to score it at 3/4 of an inch, 1.5, and 5. I am making this box for my newsletter subscribers in a different size this week, so if you haven't subscribed to my mailing list, hop on over to my blog. Okay, so now I'm just going to fold these score lines. I do need my template for this because I get a little mixed up on this one. So I've got it here where I need to cut and score, and yeah. Okay, so first what I'm going to do is I'm going to start. Okay, so here is that 3/4 inch score line right here. So that's the top of the box. So what I'm going to do is remove this section here. Then I'm going to come to that middle section, and I'm going to do the exact same thing. I want to make sure I don't cut those off. So what I'll do is just flip that over. And then I want to remove this one. Now you see why I got my template. Okay, so there. This is the top again of our box. This is the bottom of our box. So on this side over here, I'm going to remove this first block. That's the only piece I'm going to remove down here at the bottom. Now I'm just going to cut up to the score line on this one and this one. But then I'm going to give both of them a little trim. So I'm going to trim it a little to the left and a little to the right and add a little at the bottom. And this one I'm going to say it in the right order. So a little to the left, a little to the right, and in the middle. Now over here on the left side, remember the right side is missing its piece right here. I'm just going to give this right here a little trim, okay? Now, it's ready to get assembled. I'm going to put adhesive on these two tabs. And then this piece here and this piece here. So the two tabs got adhesive on the underside. These two pieces are going to get adhesive on the side that we can see. Okay? And this is one of those projects that you do want to use your Fast Fuse or your Tear and Tape. I don't have any of those with me at the moment. Okay, so now I'm just going to fold this side in. I do recommend that you start on this left side over here. Okay? It just makes a difference. So now I'm going to fold that in. I'm going to fold the bottom over first, lining that up, and then the last piece that I'm going to attach is this side panel here, and it should match perfectly. See? Now we have one more step that we're going to do. I found when I created this box that these top pieces didn't line up perfectly for whatever reason. So we're just going to give them a little trim and make them match. So a little to the right We're going to turn it over, turn the left over to the right, and now they match perfectly, okay? So now we're going to take a clothespin to close it, except we first need to decorate our clothespin. So let me get my washi tape. This is the Happy Haunting washi tape. It becomes available on September 1st. And I tore off a little too much, but it'll be okay. So now I'm just going to take my scissors. And I'm going to cover both sides of the clothespin. I was swinging my scissors around last week and someone said that it scared them. They thought that I might cut myself. The camera is mounted up above my head. It makes objects appear closer than what they really are. So I promise my scissors are nowhere near my face when I'm swinging them around. It just looks like it. Okay. Trim this again. That's not the first time someone has said that, so I have to laugh. Okay, so there's both of those, both sides. Okay, that's the back of our box. The way I can tell is I've got my seam right there. So that's the back. So I'm going to take the clothespin right there. That's so cute. Now on this box, I actually used the crushed curry baker's twine, and then that was before I added the silver, whatever this stuff's called, silver sequin. But then I'm like, oh, I want to add something up here at the top, and I didn't know what. So I'm going to change it up this time. I'm not sure which way I actually prefer, but I'm going to use the silver cord. We may not like it as well. I may want to go back to the other. So I'm just going to tie a little bow. And while I'm talking, don't forget to head over to my website, leave a comment. We will send one kit to one lucky person. I've started cutting the kits now when I cut the for the actual video. That way I don't have to do it later. Oh, that's pretty darn cute. Okay, so I'm going to attach it with a glue dot, and I'm actually just going to place the glue dot here on the clothespin so that way I can get it exactly where I want it. See? Okay, so now we're going to cut out our owl and we're going to cut out Boo. So we're using the Boo to You framelits that will be available September 1st. So I'm going to take a cutting pad and then place both of my, I'm going to place the Boo here on that one. And it doesn't, yeah, it's sticking. I was going to say it doesn't look like it's sticking, but it is. And I'm just going to line that up. Place this on top. Get the big shot. Okay, so hopefully I didn't move that. Okay, so I'm going to press out the Boo. And this doesn't need any wax paper or anything. I think those little air holes make it real easy. Okay, this little guy, I'm just going to take a couple rhinestones. You can color them with a Sharpie marker if you want, or if you have alcohol-based markers. I did actually color his nose with my marker. I didn't bring it over here to my station, so I'm just going to skip that this time. I'm going to put a couple dimensionals on the back of him. I don't know why I call him a him. He just looks like a he to me. Just like the kitty cat looks like a girl. I'm not sure why. Okay, so I just cut off a piece of the silver sequin and attaching it up here at the top. I still don't know how I feel about that. Okay, so this piece is going to go here, and then we're going to attach Boo up here. Now, I'm going to use the fine tip glue pen, And I think we were told that this was supposed to be used for sequins, but I have used it on more than one occasion on my little pieces like this, and it's stuck. So I'm going to use it until something falls off. It's actually stuck really well. Okay, so I only want to put adhesive on the bottom here. Now, just don't forget, I've already mentioned it in one of my videos. Oh, maybe it was the Stampin' Basics video. Don't forget to put your lid back on this thing, because you do not want this tip to dry out. It is awesome. In fact, I'll do that. Well, I say I'll do that. I almost need a magnifier glass to, I got it. There we go. Okay, now we're going to attach. So I'm attaching Boo first, because then I can attach the owl anywhere, okay? So Boo goes there, and I do need to give it a moment to dry. Okay, so I've given that time to dry, I think, and now all we have to do is add the owl to the front. Okay, so which do you prefer? The one with the silver or the crushed curry? I like them both. They're super cute. Okay, have a great day. Thanks a lot. Bye.